Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to the analysis of Yuleno TV. I hope you well from wherever you watch this channel. Now, Morara Kibaso, just after finishing that interview that was shared here in this channel, ladies and gentlemen, an interview where there was some confrontation between Morara Kibaso and State House spokesperson Hussein Mohamed. I believe you still remember that story. Morara is saying that the moment he finished up with that interview at the JK Live, he noticed that there was a Subaru which had a number, I think KCE. He talks about KCE.
Nilipomaliza interview Citizen,
yes,
kulikuwa na gari ambayo ilikuwa inazunguka nje ya Citizen, double cabin KCU, ambayo ilikuwa very tinted na ilikuwa na hizi lights za askari ya somewhere hapa mbele.
But on looking at, or rather searching for this Subaru which appeared to be traversing the area, the number didn't exist amongst NTSA numbers. Again, from the search, there was no insurance. Now, there's something he's pointing out here, and I wanted to pay attention very closely, ladies and gentlemen, because he says that someone has been on his trail lately, and we all know it's because of these projects which he keeps exposing. So I want to take you to another set of interview that Morara Kibaso is seen hosted, and he appears to be using the same clothes he had used during the JK Live interview. So logically, I could say that that is the second day of the interview. So before we get further on this analysis, please like this video. It's so important. If you like this video, I'm so grateful for everyone who has been liking our videos. I don't take that for granted. Subscribe to our channel if you've not subscribed before, and to existing subscribers, thank you so much for your support. Kibaso is seen in the same clothes he wore during the JK Live interview. So this is where now this story of why he is still on the same attire came up. And his response was that he had to sleep in a friend's house. So just watch this video.
Kwa hivyo sijaweza kubadilisha nguo.
Oh, hujalala kwako?
No.
What happened? Hujalala kwako? Ulitoka?
Nilipomaliza interview Citizen,
yes,
kulikuwa na gari ambayo ilikuwa inazunguka nje ya Citizen, double cabin KCU, ambayo ilikuwa very tinted na ilikuwa na hizi lights za askari ya somewhere hapa mbele. Nilipo search hiyo number plate kwa NTSA, sikuwa napata any records. Nilipoangalia kama iko na insurance,
yes,
haikuwa na insurance,
yes.
Kwa hivyo nikahofia kwamba labda maisha yangu yako hatarini, ilibidi nimruhusu dereva wangu aende,
yes,
alafu nitafute njia nyingine ya kuondoka Citizen na kwenda kwa rafiki kulala.
Ukawakwepa
gari, pikipiki,
okay, taxi. Ukitoka pale Citizen ndani ulitoka kwa gari.
Sasa nikikueleza sasa sitaweza kutumia hiyo njia tena.
Lakini utoka kwa gari, pikipiki na taxi.
Gari, pikipiki na taxi.
Lazima ukitueleza.
Very well, ladies and gentlemen, I think you've heard it from the horse's mouth that there's a trail on him. This explains why, you know, of course this was coming, because if you remember the interview between JK Live, if you remember the interview at the JK Live, he was asked whether he doesn't fear for his life, and I think this is something that was long time coming. Based on a statement from Morara Kibaso, I think this could be either a strategy to slow him down, because he exposed the head of state, that the head of state called him. He even said he has a call log, that he would unveil a call log from Safaricom, a call log that would depict a call that Ruto made to Morara Kibaso. Of course, this is not something that the state would want to have revealed, that William Ruto called him to try to contain him, to try to make him slow down on these exposes, and then he turned down the offer. You heard what the spokesperson or State House spokesperson said. He was not happy over this fact that Murara put that matter on the live television because that caught the attention of so many people. Many people talking about it. Even to date, people still talk about it. And people believe, even without proof, that indeed William Ruto called him. There's a picture I saw where Murara was stood there with the government spokesperson. So from that photo of Murara Kibaso and Isaac Mwaura, the government spokesperson, most likely, maybe Murara is trying to tell or update the government spokesperson about projects which have been stalled. Because the person who's supposed to talk extensively about projects in various ministry is the government spokesperson. Even though there's a time I overheard John Badi say that time has come whereby each and every ministry must have a spokesperson. He was trying to say that one person cannot handle all the updates of all the ministries. He was saying, in other words, that Isaac Mwaura cannot be the only person to speak on behalf of ministries, because one of the reasons why the government was suffering or suffered the Gen Z's protest because of the communication challenge, that things were not being communicated effectively. So there's a need to for each and every ministry to focus on the on that communication part. But as it stands now, the person who does the majority of the communication regarding projects is government spokesperson. That is Isaac Mwaura. So the photo where Murara Kibaso is seen with Mwaura is, in very few words I can say, is just trying to catch up with the various stalled projects. You know, one would easily want to dissect this matter this way, the issue of stalled projects, that if there was a contractor who was awarded a tender, there must have been an engineer who must have been overseeing this project. There must have been someone who approves the payment, you know, especially this is now treasury involved. And then there's the president. Now we have four players here. Now, if this matter took place during Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta's time, because most of these projects are believed to have been launched during Uhuru Muigai Kenyatta's time, then you want to ask yourself, who should you blame? Should you blame Ruto, or should you blame Uhuru, or should you blame Raila, who was not the president? Or should you blame the contractor, or the engineer, or the treasury guy who made the payment? Who is to blame? You know, if I may take you back to the issue of Goldenberg, back then in the days, you know, the story of Kamblesh Patni, and more involved back then, Musalia Mudavadi, I think, was still the finance minister. That story. When the Goldenberg case was revisited during Mwai Kibaki's time, it was not easy to link Moi with this scandal. Maybe for reasons best known to the investigators. But the person who was solely blamed here was Kamlesh Patni. And you understand what happened back then, until Kamlesh Patni became a pastor. I remember he became a pastor. He was sick for so many times during that court case, and he even became a pastor. But of course, you know what is happening in Zimbabwe now. The same issue of gold scandal is in Zimbabwe. But I don't want to talk about that matter. I was just trying to jog your mind a bit about why one would want to link the president to a scandal, but find it quite impossible or find it uneasy to find ways of linking that person. It is not possible. That is why even these projects which are being exposed by Murara Kibaso, it's not easy to link William Ruto to these projects. Because if you try to do the money trail, maybe kuna mali utapotea. If you try to link these people, kuna mali utapotea. Because one would ask himself, why did you pay for a project that had not been completed? You have a responsibility to reject that payment. The engineer, why did you make an improvement for money to be paid by the treasury? Because you're the person on the ground. The contractor received money for a project he had not done. So what should be done? I think that is where now EACC comes in, and probably the DCI and the DPP, so that people can be prosecuted. There are people on the ground who coordinated all this. So Murara Kibaso's exposes are very much in order. In fact, that's why you find that even Hussein Mohammed gave a nod, said that's okay, we love what you're doing. But the only problem is that after making that statement, Morara says he spotted a Subaru which was just hovering around, and that that forced him to allow the driver to just go with the car, and he managed to find his way to a friend's house and he slept there. That's why you find that in this second interview, Murara is seen with the same clothes he had worn when he was in the JK Live interview. So, ladies and gentlemen, what do you think about this matter? Do you think what Murara Kibaso is saying is actually happening? Because even Jeff Koinange was wondering how he managed to traverse those places, goes to very remote places and exposes projects. You've seen stones where names of people launched the projects have been removed. You've seen all those. There's a time he went to Gachagua's backyard, did the same. So these things have been happening. And even went on extent of saying Gachagua ordered people to remove those tags, you know, from those stones. And this is something that Kibaso said. So, ladies and gentlemen, just go below in your comment section and offer your reaction regarding this statement coming from Murara Kibaso. And until you catch up again, please stay safe and stay blessed.